The Helix Nebula. Its beauty has captured our world's imagination for centuries. But it wasn't until the 1960s that we found something eerily similar here on Earth and hiding in plain sight. Far at the other end of the Arab world and deep in the African deserts of Mauritania is the giant blue eye of the Sahara, a strange geological phenomenon no one knew existed until 50 years ago. Is it a meteor crater? Was it designed by aliens? Or could it be all that is left of the lost city of Atlantis? Oh, and by the way, I'm a bot. Deal with it. And this is episode 11 of The Mysterious Middle East. When the Gemini 4 mission, a four-day space orbit around Earth, was being prepared in 1965, its astronauts were asked to take photos of Earth's terrain. They were specifically asked to look out for any large circular features which might be the roots of impact structures. The assignment here was to note the impact points of meteorites that had hit Mexico, North Africa and parts of the Middle East in the past in order to get an understanding of the future. What they eventually found in the West African country of Mauritania blew their minds. The Eye of the Sahara, more formally known as the Richet structure, is a deeply eroded, almost perfectly elliptical dome with a diameter of 40 kilometers. From the ground it is impossible to see what has become known as the giant blue eye of the Sahara, as the true scale of the Mauritanian anomaly can only be taken in from the upper atmosphere. It was too large for 1960s air travelers to notice, but large enough for early space travelers to look down upon. About the location, approximately 90% of Mauritania's land is within the Sahara. Consequently, the population is concentrated in the south where weather is milder. Its people, who are a mixture of Black African and Berber, are primarily Arabic speaking, with their culture desert based, while for many years being blissfully unaware that this mega structure existed. For a while after its discovery, scientists believed that indeed it was an impact crater. But since no evidence of melted rock has ever been found, that idea was eventually dismissed. While the most commonly accepted theory suggests the structure was created more than 100 million years ago due to the plate tectonic movement of the supercontinent Pangaea, other theories delve well into the realms of the supernatural. Many believe that the Eye of the Sahara is actually the remains of the city of Atlantis, which was first described by the Greek philosopher Plato more than 2,000 years ago in three of his works. According to Plato's account, written around 360 BC, Atlantis was a major seafaring power and a continent located in the Atlantic that was extremely large, larger than ancient Libya and Turkey put together. By around 9600 BC, the island had conquered much of Western Europe and Africa and enslaved its enemies. This date would make the city nearly as old as the end of the last ice age and predates the earliest recorded city-states. According to Plato, Atlantis was circular, divided into concentric circles of land and water. In his dialogues to Maius and Critias, he states, "For it is related in our records how once upon a time your state stayed the course of a mighty host, which, starting from a distant point in the Atlantic Ocean, was insolently advancing to attack the whole of Europe, and Asia to boot. For the ocean there was at that time navigable, for in front of the mouth which you Greeks call, as you say, the Pillars of Heracles, there lay an island which was larger than Libya and Asia together, and it was possible for the travelers of that time to cross from it to the other islands, and from the islands to the whole of the continent over against them which encompasses that veritable ocean." According to Plato, Atlantis was lying in front of the Pillars of Hercule, exactly like the eye in Mauritania, southwest of the Pillars of Hercules, otherwise known as the Strait of Gibraltar, below the Atlas mountain range. Assuming that Atlantis existed, it would have done so before the Great Flood that has been described in many religious texts. With this in mind, it is also possible that parts of the ancient Sahara Desert were at one point ocean. The structure itself does contain salt, implying that it was once sea. Perhaps the Mediterranean Sea spilled into the Sahara Desert during or prior to the last ice age, and that water subsequently spilled into the Atlantic Ocean. Or it's possible the land elevations in the past were very different than they are today. Looking beyond our deserts, some alien believers have come to the conclusion that the Richet structure was created by extraterrestrials. Some say its purpose serves as a landing point for a large spaceship, Others say it is just a peaceful work of alien art, but mostly all sound insane. One theory put forth by a Dr. John Milley of the UN Panel on Extraterrestrials states the strange anomaly in Mauritania is definitely the work of the Zeebans, from the planet Zeba, naturally. He believes that these aliens are peaceful aliens and it is easy to see from these formations that they are harmonious beings and are here to help humans. However, it should be noted that the UN Panel on Extraterrestrials is not the same as the United Nations Office for Outer Space Affairs, which is an official part of the United Nations Secretariat. Instead, the panel is mostly recognized by an online tabloid called Weekly World News. Therefore, it's probably not necessary for me to go into any more detail about the Zeebans and their planet Zeba, because like the UN Panel of Extraterrestrials, they probably do not exist. However, in all seriousness, due to the highly symmetrical nature of the anomaly, as well as its immense size and scale, the Rishat structure has captured the imaginations of the few people who know of its existence, and it is a shame that it isn't even considered as one of the major wonders of the natural world. Before watching this video, had you heard of the Rishat structure, and if so, what do you think it is? Is it nature, man-made or extraterrestrial? And don't forget to leave a comment, like, share and subscribe.